What's good? It's your boy Cali Pitts on KGCN Radio, the Good Conversation Show. This is Soul Saturdays, and y'all know the slogan, so I won't say it. Wait a minute. Yes, I will. Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the hits. What's up, ladies and gents? It's your boy Cali Pitts of KGCN Radio, and this show is brought to you by our lifetime sponsor, RTV. If you're not watching RTV, then what are you watching? RTV can be found on Fire Stick and Roku Television. When you come across that red R, subscribe and join the family. Thank you. Welcome, everyone. This sponsorship has been brought to you by the Lois Curtis Campus. The Lois Curtis Campus is located in Topeka, Kansas. If you're looking to help, support, or even donate, you can reach the Lois Curtis Campus at www.loiscurtiscampus.org. Also, info@loiscurtiscampus.org. And by phone, the Lois Curtis Campus can be reached at 1-785-233-4572. Again, that's 1-785-233-4572. Thank you.
I'm not.
No doubt, no doubt. You in the mix with your boy, Cali Pitts. This is a low, slow morning, Saturday, soul to soul Saturday. We definitely like to thank y'all for being here, tapping in with your boy. We appreciate everybody's attention. We appreciate everybody's time, no doubt. Right now, I want to give a shout out to everybody who tapped in with us. Miss Maven, I see you. Flash, I see you. Kelly, I see you. No doubt, thank y'all for tapping in so far. We got more people than that in here. Let me check it out, man, all the way. Volume sound a little crazy this morning. It could be me. Let me see something. Yeah, there you go. It was me. How y'all feeling this morning, though, man? Y'all woke up with that love on y'all? I hope y'all did. We them boys in the building as well. My beautiful wife in the building as well. No doubt, man. Let me see if we can get this shit cracking off the right way. Again, I'm just waking up. Got my coffee in hand. Man, no doubt. No doubt, Flash. I appreciate you, bro. No doubt. Let's get it, man.
Welcome to the good life. Welcome to the good life.
The wait is over.
Welcome to the good life.
And after all the talk, all I gotta say is,
welcome to the good life.
You're welcome. You're all welcome. Like we always do at this time. I go for mine. I get the shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky.
And get pulled over in they new V. The good life, let's go on a living spree. They say the best things in life are free. The good life, it feel like Atlanta, it feel like LA, it feel like Miami, it feel like NY. Summertime shy, ah. So I roll through good, y'all pop the trunk, I pop the hood, Ferrari. And she got the goods, and she got that. I got to look, sorry. Yo, it's got to be, cause I'm seasoned. Haters give me them salty looks, Larry's. 50 told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. It's just like,
I go for mine, I got to shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky. Yeah, I go for mine, I got to shine.
The girls who ain't on TV cause they got more
than the models.
The good life, so keep it coming with the bottles. So she feel booze like she bombed at Apollo. The good life, it feel like Houston, it feel like Philly, it feel like DC, it feel like BA or the Bay or yay. Hey, this is the good life. Homie, tell me what's good. Why I only got a problem when you in the hood?
Welcome to the good life.
Like I'm new in the hood. The only thing
I wish it was the
hood. Welcome to the good life.
He probably think he could, but I don't think he should.
Welcome to the good life.
50 told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. The good life.
I go for mine.
Yeah.
I got to shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky. I go for mine. I got to shine.
Champagne on a plane while getting some buckets. She said, I never seen snakes on a plane. Whether you broke or rich, you gotta get this. Having money's that everything that having it is. I was splurging on trips, but when I get my car back activated, I'm back to Vegas. Cause I always had a passion for flashing. Before I had it, I closed my eyes and imagined the good life.
Better than the life I lived when I thought that I was gonna go crazy. And now my grandmama ain't the only girl calling me baby.
Us before me in the building. Shout out. Shout out to Sharp Body. Was good.
chilling with my little bro, having me a cup of coffee. You're listening to the Good Conversation Show Radio on Podbean. Y'all tap in. Come on, let's have this conversation.
Jay Flash, Maven, I still need them drops from y'all, no doubt. Y'all know the email, kgcnradio@gmail.com. I would love a drop from you, too. Was good.
I love music, and every time I hear something hot, it makes me want to move. It makes me want to have fun, but it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here, it makes me want to
let it go. Can't let this thing called love get away from you. Feel free right now. Go do what you want to do. Can't let nobody take it away.
Tony, thanks for tapping into the chat. No doubt. LB, I see you.
It's been a long week. I put in my hardest. Gonna live my life. Feels so good.
when I'm walking past the mirror. Don't stress through the night at a time in my life. Ain't worried about if you feel it. Got my head on straight, I got my vibe right. I ain't gonna let you kill it. See, I won't change my life.
Y'all for hitting them hearts. We encourage everybody to do it when they get a chance, y'all. They free, and that's how you help the show.
Everything is alright. The atmosphere is You try to have
No doubt. Flash Pac is the GOAT when it comes to dropping real life scenarios on music. You know what I mean? A lot of people go fantasy. Pac go 100% real shit. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I loved about him, because damn near everything he say can relate to you as a young black male out here in this world. So it is what it is, man. That's why he the one. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I say there's no number ones for me just all over it. Cats are number one in they lane. And some lanes are just they lane and can't nobody else jump in it. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, Eminem, number one in his lane. Can't nobody else jump in it. Nas, number one in his lane. You know what I'm saying? Can't nobody really jump in it. You know what I'm saying? Jay-Z, it's a lot of cats that's number one in they lane and you can't fuck with it. Scarface, number one. Cube, number one. DOC, number one. And, you know, people can have a problem with it saying it can't be like that. Bullshit, if it can't, it's like that for me. Let's go.
Girls, you know you better. Watch out. Some guys are only about that thing, that thing, that thing.
What's good?
It's been 3 weeks since you were looking for your friend, the one you let hit and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to bend your man? You act like you and him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then you probably can. Talking out your neck saying you're a Christian, a Muslim, sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna when the repercussions spin, showing off your ass cause you're thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gem, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. And you still defending them now. Lauren is only human. You don't think I haven't been through the same predicament. Let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because it's sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again. And it's Tim's and it's women, him and his men. Come in the club, I come to dance. Don't care who they your friend, popping yeah.
Like you got yeah.
Let's not pretend. The one to pack pissed out by the waist, man. Crissed out by the casement. Still the name of this basement. The pretty face, man. Claiming that they did a bit, man. Need to take care of their 3 and 4 kids. In the face in court case when the child support late. Money take your heart breaking. Now you wonder why women hate men. The sneaky silent man. The punk domestic violence man. The quick job asking to stop acting like boys and be men. How you gonna win when you ain't right within? How you gonna win when you ain't right within? How you gonna win when you ain't right within? Come again. Yo, come again.
Nothing but the hit.
What's cracking? You already know who it is. It's your boy Boss Hizzle, Ask I Records, El Presidente, and I'm chilling with my boy Cali Piss on KGCN. Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the hits.
Is this thing on? Word.
So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees.
Oh, shit.
So what, we go out.
Oh, let me get a lighter.
That's how it's supposed to be.
Cause you know I'm a ass fucking
up. Young and wild.
Keep that in there.
Free.
So what? I keep them rolled up, sagging my pants, not caring what I show. Keep it real with my niggas, keep it playing for these hoes. It look clean, don't it? Washed it the other day, watch how you lean on it. Eat me some 501 jeans on it, roll joints bigger than King Kong's fingers, and smoke them hoes down to the stingers. You a class clown, and if I skip for the damn with your bitch smoking gray,
you know what? It's like I'm 17 again, peach fuzz on my face. Looking on the case, trying to find a hella taste. Oh my God, I'm on the chase. Chevy, it's getting kind of heavy. Relevant, selling it, dipping away. Time keeps slipping away. Zipping the safe, flipping for pay. Tipping like I'm dripping in paint. Up front, four blunts like a leaf. I put the wheat in
so
a jar.
So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees. So what, we go out. That's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
And I don't even care. Me and my team in here, it's gonna be some weed in the air. Tell them Mac,
blowing everywhere we going, and now you know when I step right up, get my lighter so I can light up.
That's how it should be done. Soon as you're thinking you're down, find how to turn things around. Now things are looking up.
From the ground up, pound up this Taylor gang. So turn my sound up and mount up and do my thing.
Now I'm chilling, fresh out of class, feeling like I'm on my own and I could probably own a building. Got my own car, no job, no children. Had a size project, me and Mac killed it.
THC, MAC, DEV, HD3, hi, it's me. This is us, we gon' fuss and we gon' fight and we gon' roll and live
on. So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees. So what, we go out. That's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
Yeah, roll one, smoke one. When you live like this, you're supposed to party. Roll one, smoke one, and we all just having fun. So we just roll one, smoke one. When you live like this, you're supposed to party. Roll one, smoke one, and we all just having fun.
So up, we get drunk. So up, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. And we don't care who sees. So up, we go out.
Dougie, y'all told me he been on some positive shit, yeah, yeah. Lately, I just wanna show up and body some shit, yeah, yeah. Always been a little mathematician. Lately, this cash I'm getting got me losing count of these bags. I've been moving too fast. Hard times don't last. Remember when cops are rats talking out my ass. Boy, you ain't shit but a bitch with a badge.
All my life.
All my life.
They be trying to keep me down. This time, never thought I'd make it out. No, no, no. All my life, they be trying to keep me down.
trying to keep me down. I decided I had to finish, but the media called me a menace. I just sat with the mayor and politicians, I'm trying to change the image. You can't blame my past no more, I come from the trenches. Some said I'd never be a superstar, but I know I'm different. I'm a voice, but the system ain't give me a choice. Know some people that still undeployed. I know a felon who trying to get void. Child support, your only support. For a visit, I'm going through courts. Went to jail, they was chaining me up. And you know that I'm famous as fuck. See how you gon' joke about stimulus, but they really had came in the clutch. I know some kids wanna hurt themselves. Stop trying to take drugs, I refer to myself. Trying to better myself, trying to better my health, but
all my life,
all my life,
they be trying to keep me down.
All this time,
never thought I'd make it out.
No, no,
they couldn't take me, they couldn't take me.
No,
all my life,
all my life,
trying to keep me down.
First generation ghetto nigga, cold world, hello niggas. Made it out of the city with my head on straight. Niggas keep shooting up the let out. Y'all enjoy the pill, gotta get out. Cause the shit that I spit out is a cheat code, like I'm facing a Rico. A high nigga put a hit out, and another one, and another one. I got like 100 of them by the lap, niggas, so they think they ahead of me. But I'm really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they bad, fucking up the little crumbs that they had. A reminder to humble yourself, this shit could be gone in an instant. Me, I'm running long distance, all pistons firing. I've been stuck between maybe retiring and feeling like I'm just not hitting my prime. These days, seeing rappers be dying way before they even getting they shine. I never even heard a little buddy till somebody murder a little buddy. Now I'm on the phone searching little buddy name. Gotta play in his tunes all day in my room. Thinking, damn, this shit wicked to get their names buzzing. Some niggas just gotta go lay in a tomb. And media thirsty for clicks. I got a new rule. If you ain't ever posted a rapper when he was alive, you can't post about him after he get hit. It's simple. It's the principle. On any tempo, I'm invincible. Don't even rap. I just vent to you. I'd rather that than an interview. Most days, fuck them all like I'm going through a whole phase. Young niggas shoot out the whip like road rage. I pray all of my dogs stay so paid. And the only thing to kill him is old age.
All my life,
they be trying to keep me down.
All this time,
never thought I'd make it out.
No, no,
no,
all my life,
they be trying to keep me down.
I see you. Ask Got Radio, I see you.
So stop playing.
Listening, I see you.
Let's make love like we first met.
No doubt, listening. I got you.
Give me all your love and don't stop. I love waiting when you reach the top. Come into my bedroom, honey. What I got will make you spend money. And I said,
listening, I already had this up. My bad. Last teacher, thanks for tapping in.
Looking back for my years, I guess I shed it some tears.
Petra, thanks for tapping in.
Told myself time and time again, this time I'm gonna win. But another fight, things ain't right, I'm losing again. Takes a fool to lose twice, start all over again. Think I better let it go. Looks like another love TKO. Oh, think I better let it go. What you think about it, girl? Oh yeah. Try to take control of the love, love took control of me. Cause to lose all false sense of time and have a change of mind. Taking the
I have a system, so I use all
things of a two-time loser. Trying to hold on, but faith is gone. It's just another sad song. I think I better let it go. What you say about it? Looks like another love TKO. Oh, 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 oh. Yes, I think I better let it go.
Let it go, baby.
Oh, baby.
Looks like another love TKO.
time and have a change of mind. Taking the bumps and the bruises of all the things of a two-time loser. See, I try to hold on, my faith is gone. It's just another sad song. But I think I better let it go. Let it go. Cause it looks like I'm bad.
China.
Used and abused.
Conversation show, KGCN radio, y'all. No doubt, this is Soul to Soul Sunday.
Ain't it funny that the way you live shows on your all over your face, and the smile you used to wear seems a little bit out of place. So you say you're in your prime. Baby, don't always
No doubt, no doubt. Thank y'all for tapping in with your boy over here on a good conversation show, KGCN Radio. Y'all know how we do it. We at the top of the hour, so it's time to hit y'all with a temperature check, and I'm going to get right back out y'all way and play this music. Right now, the time is 10 a.m. on the dot. Y'all know I'm on the West Coast, California, Pacific Standard Time. The temperature is currently at 66 degrees. Our high today will be 82. The low will be 55. No reports on wind gusts, even though we are a 420 friendly show. We encourage you to smoke your marijuana. Have a good time, but be responsible. Please don't smoke and drive. Don't smoke and operate heavy machinery. You have a responsibility to keep yourself safe and others. And we also have a few sponsors over here. Y'all want to tap into that if that's okay with y'all. Let's go.
What's up, ladies and gents? It's your boy, Cali Pitts of KGCN Radio, and this show is brought to you by our lifetime sponsor, RTV. If you're not watching RTV, then what are you watching? RTV can be found on Fire Stick and Roku Television. When you come across that red R, subscribe and join the family. Thank you.
Spread them all over the world. From
We do have a teacher in our group. She not here right now, but we'll make sure she know.
At the end of the day, when the wind is soft and warm, ooh, but it makes the flowers sway. When the sun...
My name is Callie, like California.
And it takes a lovely form. That's the golden time of day. Whoa.
Kelly, I see you. Thank you for that extra love. We encourage everybody to hit them hearts when they get a chance. Y'all, they free, and that's how you help the show. Y'all, we reaching that top of the hour. I'm gonna bring a couple of y'all up. We're gonna talk to the last teacher, see what her skill set is and what she's trying to get into. We got a lot of connections and things over here like that. We're gonna let Shardy B come up, give us a little bit of poetry. If y'all in the mood, y'all, it's a Saturday morning. This is Soul to Soul Saturday on KGCN Radio.
Look above and give me your heart.
Then I look at you, and the world's alright with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Impossible to face when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Then I look at you and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
This sponsorship has been brought to you by the Lois Curtis Campus. The Lois Curtis Campus is located in Topeka, Kansas. If you're looking to help, support, or even donate, you can reach the Lois Curtis Campus at www.loiscurtiscampus.org. Also, info@loiscurtiscampus.org. And by phone, the Lois Curtis Campus can be reached at 1-785-233-4572. Again, that's 1-785-233-4572. Thank you. No doubt, no doubt. You in the building with your boy Cali Pitts over here on KGCN Radio, the Good Conversation Show. And I got a couple of my sis stars in the building, Shorty B and the Real China. And we also have a new caller in the building, the Last Teacher. No doubt, no doubt. Shorty, like say hello to the people.
What's popping? How y'all feeling today? I hope y'all have a good day and y'all vibe level is up there, because I know I am. How you doing, big bro? China, how you doing, sis?
Not complaining.
Last teacher, how you doing?
China, what about you? Would you like to say hello to the people?
Good morning, good afternoon, beautiful people. How are you, Shorty B? And is that the Last Teacher? And what's up, Callie? What's up, everybody? Happy Saturday.
No doubt, right? Blessed to be, not blessed, love to be breathing. I feel love. God put his hand on us, me, you, and absolutely, everybody else that's here. No doubt. We get to share this moment. So, Last Teacher, can you tap in, talk to us, let us know about you a little bit?
Hey, everyone. It is Last Teacher at School podcast. Yes, I'm actually a guy, but I teach second grade right now, still in the game, and the reason why I came on to Podbean and podcasting in general is because there's so many of my sisters and brothers that are in school and they're struggling. And I want them to share their stories, because when we share our stories, we uplift and we give that strength and hope to stay in the game, because our children need us, society need more teachers, good teachers. And so that's the main reason I'm here. And I was listening to the songs and I was just like, ooh, I'm vibing, man. That last song actually was right when I was born, but my mom sort of sheltered me. And so a lot of my music comes from before I was born that I'm like really jamming to. So thank you for inviting me on. And I just want everybody to know that united and focused, we can achieve the impossible. And it just takes those people who are willing to be united with certain people that they don't want to be united with, and be focused on that one goal so we can all come together.
No doubt, no doubt. And we had a conversational topic over here about people doing the jobs that they want to do and not doing jobs that they settle for because it don't bring the right emotion to the occupation. You know what I mean? So we definitely need teachers out there, but we need people who want to be teachers. You know what I'm saying? We need people who have the patience to teach children, for one. So no doubt, I agree with
that. That's true. That's true. Yeah. And there's people who are there who they want to be teachers. They want to make a lasting impact. And I realize because they don't stick with it to the end, because they don't have that support, or they don't feel valued, or they just don't have the tips and tricks financially to have a side hustle or do have some passive income, they decide, you know what? It's too much. I'm going to go into this other realm where I'm able to get more money. But then they realize, snap, I really miss the impact that I was making on different families and different children. So I'm trying to be in that gap, help with the financial tips, but also just help with the soul and the strategies, especially for the men who are going from single teaching to married teaching, to stay in the game and for them to have more time with their family as well as make that impact at school.
What percentage of teaching, how valuable is the parent being a part of the teaching process, 0 to 100? What's the percentage of value?
0 to 100. In all honesty, it's 100. Think about where it came from. There were zero teachers in the past, so to speak, okay? It was all the parents sharing knowledge to everyone, all right? And there was the teachers in the different groups teaching the parents. But for the children, everybody was at home. And then I'm going back way thousands of years ago. And then it came to where, okay, let's have a school for children where instead of having the parents teach everything, they would go to the school and they would learn. Okay. And those schools were small, but the main thing is the parent is the number one teacher of their children. And as we were agricultural, as we were rural living in the past, the sons and daughters, they learned tasks, they learned responsibility, they learned math by actually helping out mom and dad with the business or helping with inventory of certain things, okay? But it came where we grouped up into the cities more and more, where, okay, our children aren't helping out with as many tasks. And so this may be a little drastic, but it seems nowadays that children are more accessories than actual human beings that have responsibility and they are going to attribute to society. So right. I want to bring back that understanding that every child is important, and we need to, not just teachers, but us as a whole need to understand, okay, this child is here for this purpose and help develop those skills. And right. The parent should be the main one fostering that and basically letting the teacher know, hey, my son, he's a born leader. He needs help in this. Like, it should be the teacher's like, okay, parent, tell me what you want me to do for your son. You
right,
get me?
Right.
But it's sad that it went the other way around, where it's the teachers telling the parents.
Now, as a teacher, again, I have thoughts, and they just my thoughts and perspective on things, but as a teacher, I believe that teachers should be versed, because I speak for the urban communities. I come from the urban communities. So I speak for those people. Now, should the teachers, they self be versed and PTS traumatic syndrome because of the kids they're dealing with?
I would say that's real, and I want for teachers to understand that when we are just understanding, not to be specifically versed in that, but just having that air of understanding where we're seeking to hear and just listen instead of being prideful, so to speak. You get me? Like, yes, we went through training. We went through all the educational portions, but when we are there as humble servants, knowing that, okay, I know my subject, but I don't know your child, then that makes everything better. And so, yes, that would be helpful. Other social emotional learning would be helpful. Different other strategies would be helpful, but it starts from the paradigm of, okay, I'm going to be coachable in your child. And as I'm coachable in your child and your family, then I'm able to bring my expertise to help with everything that you're sharing with about your specific family. Does that make sense?
Make all the sense to me. Make all the sense to me, but I'm just one person. No doubt, man. Just again. Man, just the whole process of talking to someone who wants to be a teacher in this day and age, and I applaud you for one. For being a teacher of the early stages in children's lives, which is very important, where they're most misunderstood. You know what I mean?
I do. I want you to know that I'm only teaching second grade because God brought me down to second grade. As humans, we go through levels and we learn. So I started off with the people who I was living with about a decade and 12 years ago. They told me I should go and be a teacher, you know, use my degree to good use. I had a minor in French. And so I walked in saying, you know what? I am your new French teacher. Got crickets all around, but the receptionist helped me and brought me to the right person. And they said, well, we have a Spanish position available. I walked in there, got the position upon the interview, and the teacher that was there had tenure. So she was just handing them Packards. She was like, I'm waiting for the time to go. The time got there where she was going to get paid no matter what. And I was just thrown in, so to speak. And this is as a long-term sub. But with that experience, I came in with the understanding, okay, we're going to make this a family. I'm going to try my very best to be the best teacher that you needed. Not a sub, not any title. Like, I'm going to be that teacher for you. And right now, we just ended Nevada Day yesterday because I'm over in Vegas. And it was almost as if I was battle-born. But the whole thing is, it's all by the grace of God. And when you let God lead your life into different ways, what happened later on that year, two of the teachers who had their license, who had experience, they thought I'd been teaching longer than them because of the classroom management, because of the certain, professional development insights that I placed inside the classroom and the growth that they had. And so it's just by the grace of God. I'm only in second grade right now. Because I have a son, and yes, he's on the spectrum, and my lovely wife has taught me more and more compassion in order to deal with the certain things that need to happen for him to grow and for him to be trained. And we had a wonderful day yesterday, and we've had a brilliant couple months because I was able to be humble and know that I have skills, know that I have training, but listen and be more compassionate about that. And so even in my first week of teaching, the second grade, the parents were like, wow, like you've done so much in just 1 week. And that was only by the grace of God, because I'm just being myself. And I want to help other teachers to know that when you allow God to be in your life, you're going to go through certain trials, but you stay focused on the word of God. You stand on his word, and as you stand, you're going to survive through it. Then you're going to thrive through it, and people are going to be talking about your exploits, and you're just going to be like, I was just here being myself. You get me? So my compassion is greatly due to my wife, who we've had our struggles, our battles, for years, but we came together, and that coupled with my son was able to make me prepared for second grade, because all throughout the teaching, it's been middle school, fifth and fourth grade. Those are the grades that I've taught, middle school, fifth and fourth grade. So to come down to second grade, I thought it would be a challenge, but actually it's like, okay, I got this.
Yeah, I would assume the fourth and fifth graders would be more of a challenge, because, you know, they're a little more set, you know what I mean, than a second grader or whatever. But no, nah, that's still young youth, and that's still flowers or a congratulations to you for still dealing with the youth of this world, you know what I mean, because that's so important to what our future is. And it starts early, you know what I mean? So, thank you.
What you said is true. Like fourth and fifth, it would seem like they're harder. Yes, I'm right there. And the reason why I was attracted, so to speak, or maybe not attracted, that's a bad word, but like I was gravitated towards teaching middle school, teaching fifth grade, was really because I needed that teacher when I was in middle school. You get me? Right. And because I didn't have that teacher, I felt like I was alone, you know, and I wanted to be that force. Obviously, I started teaching when I was a single male, okay? And I didn't have my father growing up with me. And my mother, she was working a lot, and she only came to my course performances. I played sports, two different seasons of sports. She didn't come to any of those games. She just came for when I was singing. But either way, with that, I wanted to be that sort of surrogate father for those that didn't have their parents supporting them after school or even in school. And so I go from that to now being married, now having my own son. And it's a struggle because it's like, okay, I'm spending hours at school being great, but then my home life is not great at all. And then I'm like, okay, well, I focus on home, but then school isn't right. And so the strategies that I had for middle school, they were good because you need to be strict. You need to be hard, so to speak. But then again, I went down to fifth grade and fourth grade, and I had to be more nurturing. I had to be more patient and gentle, okay? And so after I hit that up, God put me back in middle school and had me understand, okay, now you know how to be warm, strict. That's where you're loving. And a lot of, I'll make the generalization, but a lot of, especially black female teachers, they do this very well. They're that mama of the school where it's just like, they can be mean with the look, but the kids will still be like, at the end of the day, oh, I want to hug Mrs. Hopkins or Mrs. Barksdale or something. And they'll be like, no, Miss Barksdale, I'm scared of her, but she gives me a hug every day, or, you know, she gives me some snacks or something like that. And so in order to get that warm, strict as a male, I needed time and I needed some help from the other teachers and definitely my wife so that I could be more nurturing. And then after that time, bam. So I'm with you. Yes, it was definitely more difficult with fourth grade and middle school. And so I think that's another reason why, other than that nurturing portion and patience, like second grade is it seems very easy.
No doubt. Man, I just like to say again, flowers for the teacher position, and more than that, just wanting to be the teacher. Having an understanding that parenting with teaching is the course, in the urban communities. So many parents will send their kids to school for everything. You know what I mean? That's the teaching. Go to school. What you learn at school is, and like you said, it starts with the home. There used to be no teacher. So the parent was the teacher, the professor, the everything. But again, in this day and age, we know what time it is. We know what we living in. just to have people be where they want to be or understand they where they should be doing what they should be doing is an awesome situation, man. So again, flowers.
Could I ask the people on here to type it in, if it's okay. Write down just who was that memorable teacher in your life, other than your mom, other than your dad. Like, who was that memorable teacher in your life that really impacted, and what grade were you in when you had that teacher? Is that okay to ask the crowd that?
Yeah, fine. It's the people show.
Yeah, all right, yeah. And then that will bring out more stories and what we learn from that one teacher, we're actually becoming teachers to other people that we influence. We focus on our one circle of influence, which is ourself and our duties. But then the people that are in our close range, because of the example that we have in our life, and this is not just with teaching, this is just with life, by doing our job or duty or, you know, the volunteer position as excellently as we can be, then we actually expand our circle of influence. Exactly what you're doing right here. You're doing this radio show wonderfully, and then people are gravitating onto it. So your radio show is going to grow. Your circle of influence is going to grow just by, you know, doing those 1, 2, 3 things perfectly as best you can be. So go ahead, share out everybody. Who's your teacher that you remember, and let us know, what did you learn from them, or how did they really impact your life?
Well, China in the building, she said, Mr. Smith, China, you want to talk about it?
Sure. When I was in fourth grade, I had gotten hit by a car. And that was probably like in April of that year. So unfortunately, I had to take the last 2 months of school off and go to summer school. So it was kind of hard getting acclimated to the fifth grade because I lost so much time, you know, in the fourth grade. So my teacher at that time just was really sweet, very caring, very nurturing, and very patient with me because I did have a head injury. And I remember that most, just very gentle and took a lot of time with me. And, you know, that meant a lot, you know? So, yeah, that's my little story.
No doubt. Thank you for sharing. Yeah. Shorty V said, Miss Love, seventh grade. Shorty, you in the building? Talk about it.
Yeah, I'm here. I was in seventh grade. I got picked at a lot during school. Y'all know that, but. And seventh grade, I got bullied a lot. And then, like, Miss Love, she stuck up for me, you know what I mean? A lot of teachers really don't, some do. But then, like, she was like, you can be whatever you want to be. Just don't worry about it. You gonna show them when you grow up who you are. And then, hey, they ain't seen me in a minute, but when they do see me, I'm gonna let them know. Like, I have a whole family. I got a podcast popping. You know what I mean? So I'm here.
No doubt. Well, for me, it was Miss Anderson, and I was in high school by this time. I think 9th, 10th grade. And, you know, I thought I was the shit because I had money. I'm a celebrity. I'm on TV. I'm touring the world and shit. So Miss Anderson, she was my algebra teacher. And no matter what, this woman would see me out of class. She grabbed me by my ear, like literally like an elementary kid, pull me into the class. This is when teachers had phones in their classes and shit. And she would call my mama and make me talk to my mama like, he out of class. He ain't doing what he's supposed to do. He think he missed the big stuff. And I just never forget that, you know what I'm saying? Even when she wasn't teaching me, she was still caring about me. So, yeah. That's mine right there. But with that being said, y'all, we're going to get into some music. I hope y'all enjoying the time with us. We vibing. Let's go. Some educational music, I should say. Marco Wayne, what's good with you? How you feeling this Saturday morning, brother?
Something's going on, there's something's going wrong, it's still going on. And I do it for the love, I do it for the hip hop. Young nigga came in the game with a big lock. Hip hop saved my life, bro. Tupac. Fresh out of slumber, black winter killing the summer. Fuck your feelings, you can't touch this.
won't. When you fake, I got cake, nigga. I said you already know. Plus, I already got one rolled up. That's what's up. I'll be back, let me change my clothes. Nigga gon' blaze up. I got yaks, gon' pull one up. I came back and we smoked till our eyes got low. The homie left and I had to make a run to the stove. It was a cool day, so I decided to walk. Credit to an old head, he decided to talk. Damn, even though I didn't have the time, I gave it to him anyway. Remember what your parents say. Respect, respect your elders, then respect you. Alright, I'm going home. Okay, nephew. Hey, remember, don't do what the rest do. I told him, copy that. You know me, I'm not a copycat. Continue with my mission up the block. That's when I heard shots, just some tires burn out. That brought concern out. I ran to the corner to see the turnout. And what happened? You know, another car wash. As I watch young Branks hang, this a daily thing. And he ain't even bang, he just like to hang. What a shame. And yeah, he was good with the dribbles, but you gotta keep your head on the swivel when we living, y'all. But I'm thankful, 30 seconds removed, that could've been me laid out in a pool of blood. Face down, can't move or budge. I gotta ask people, where's the love? Wait. I know we equal, but are we all evil? Cause every day is the sequel from the shit that we see from our people. I know you gotta do what beat you, but you can leave a nigga leaving and breathing to keep it even. Cause for Malcolm and Martin, let's keep believing, even if the kids are only reason, let's keep the G blood. I know we got a lot more to gain, but we a long way from where we became. Let's break a chain. On and on and on, it's going on and on and on and on, it's going on and on and on, and something's going on, and something's going wrong, and still going on. And I do it for the love, I do it for the hip hop. Young nigga came to the game with a big Glock. Hip hop saved my life, work, Tupac.
No doubt. That was your boy himself, Cali Pitts. Something's going on, y'all. That will be on a new and upcoming album. No doubt. Thank y'all for tapping in. Our Focus Media in the building, man. Do you have a story in an age and a grade where a teacher impacted your life?
Yeah, I got a few, man. Peace and love to everybody on. But it started early for me, man. My mom, she wanted something different. So, she sent me to, private school. So from pre-kindergarten, I learned how to, and for whatever reason, I'm forgetting this teacher's name, but she's special to me. But pre-kindergarten, I learned how to read, write, and do math. I was doing multiplication in pre-kindergarten. By the time I got into third grade, Miss Peak, this is when, they could still whoop you at, private school. So, Miss Peak had a paddle called Dr. Pepper. And if you got out of line, she smack you on your ass with that Dr. Pepper paddle. I remember getting a few of those, but, she also, saw something in me and a buddy of mine, and she sent us on a field trip with the eighth grade. The eighth grade was going to preach at a church in Oakland. And she sent me and my buddy Lamar, as representatives of the third grade to preach a sermon at this church. I don't remember what the name of the church was, but I do remember that she made us memorize our 10-page sermon while the eighth grader didn't have to memorize theirs. I remember that. But however I did it, I memorized that 10-page sermon. And she helped me, and she instilled some things in me with that. And my eighth grade teacher, Miss G, seventh and eighth grade teacher, she was just amazing, man. It was just the love of humanity that she displayed, you know what I mean, on top of her love for teaching and growing young minds. It was just something, it was awesome. Like I said, I went to private school up until high school. You know what I mean? So I grew up singing the Black National Anthem, in the morning before school. We didn't sing the Pledge of Allegiance. You know, I did a same third grade with Miss Peak. I did a speech on stage on Garrett A. Morgan. One of his inventions back in the day was the traffic light. green, yellow, red. Garrett A. Morgan, a black man, created that. So like I say, these are things that I'll never forget because it taught me that I could do things that I hadn't done before. I'd never, you know what I mean, memorized a 10-page anything at that time. And I mean, I got to get on stage and talk about people that I didn't know about and some people that I did. And then, like I say, Miss G, 7th and 8th grade, she was just so wonderful at letting us know that whatever it is in our minds that we want to do, you can do it. It's going to take work to get it done. There's going to be trials and tribulations on the way through it. But whatever it is, you can get it done. So that's where, you know, my work ethic was built from home, like the teacher was saying. And peace and love to you, man, and continued blessings. My name is Dre. I run R Focus Media. If there's anything I can do to help what you're doing, let me know. Peace and love to you having your child. Man, that does take a person to a different level. So continue to grow. And like I said, if there's anything I can do or we, let us know, man. We here. But yeah, blessings for those that help instruct me on how to be and how to maneuver.
No doubt. No doubt. What about you, Marco Wayne? We went to school together a lot, bro. So any teachers from your young life or just period through your life that influenced you, bro?
Mine started from basketball, bro. Majority of my basketball coaching just instilled in me how to be a man, bro, because my dad was around, but he wasn't. He always was working. So that nigga didn't too much teach me anything. So my basketball coaches taught me a whole lot. It was all my basketball coaches. So that's why I did all my shit.
No doubt. No doubt. Man, that's what's up, man. Appreciate everybody tapping in with the stories, man. Telling us a piece of your life, your childhood. Y'all know we appreciate that over here, man. It's crazy how, you know, a lot of us grow up without our pops in our life and things like that, but still grow up to be these strong women and men and understand that what we didn't have is not what we not supposed to supply to our children. It's good to see people grown and not selfish to what real life is. A lot of people live in a fantasy world, man, and they don't see faults in they self. They only see fault in other people. And that's just saying, man, one of the craziest things. And one of the things that I definitely try to do, and I'm being more consistent with it, should I say, these days, is finding out my responsibility even in the things that I think is being done wrong to me. And I think that's something we all got to do. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, this goes out to all the deadbeat dads, all the fathers who could be there and they just ain't being there. This go out to you. Remember, them kids gotta grow up and they gonna feel a way and they gonna have a feeling. Don't mean they don't love you for helping create them, but it means they will have a feeling though. It's another song that's off my new upcoming album. We Saturday vibing, so I'm gonna give y'all some sneak peeks.
Saying I'm Jesus and nothing more. Yeah. I'd like to welcome y'all to the beginning of an ending. No doubt. It's only right I give it to you how I came in. I'ma go out the same way. 316. This is 316. Let's go. Dear Father, how you left a nigga? Without a thought about my future, kept it stepping, nigga. I only know you cause I see you every morning, nigga. My reflection in your image made me hate you, nigga. I wondered if you thought about me when you hit that dope. Or was the dope the reason that you really couldn't cope? That's probably why you beat my mama, but I never know. And when I asked you, you said let it go, but nigga, no. Cause when I needed you, nigga, you would never show. To the point if I needed you, you would never know. They say give what you get, so I ain't got no love. And you the same motherfucker who I got that
not sorry. I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. Dear Father,
getting high, let the smoke pass by. I'm getting high, watch the smoke pass by.
Dear Father, I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. I'm sorry, I'm not sorry.
I'm getting high, blow it out.
I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. I'm sorry, I'm not sorry.
Hey, Bob, it's been a wild nigga, wild nigga. My son getting married, I'm a proud nigga. They say I must be hot, not as mild nigga. I ain't gon' air his ass out like a child nigga. But respectfully, definitely, I'll be pressing the issue. And I'll keep it all true. They can't say that I diss you. Let's just make it official. You don't fuck with me, I don't fuck with you. Let's just blame it on who? Whoever the fuck you choose, nigga. I followed the rules, then made it my own. I should've called Tyrone, you was never at home. Now that I'm grown, I don't condone the shit that you want. Love it or leave it, believe it. Even though I came from those stones, I ain't cut from your cloth. Since the day I was born, I was a burden. But now I illustrate it, greatest in burden. This is celebration, nigga. Breaking cycles and curses. I come from the surface, so I research it, then I resurface.
Dear Father, I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. I'm sorry, I'm not sorry.
Dear Father, getting high, let the smoke pass by. I'm getting high, watch the smoke pass by.
Dear Father, I'm sorry, I'm not sorry. I'm sorry, I'm not sorry.
No doubt, no doubt. That's some of that new music coming off my album again, man. When you a father, you have an opportunity, man, before it's too late to connect with your children. Don't let your issues with the woman stop you from being a father. Don't let the hate for the law stop you from being a father. You got rights as well, man. I know it get hard sometimes, but the kid is worth it. You know what I mean? They worth it. They worth us going through whatever we got to do, man. Them ups and downs, them highs and lows, them peaks and valleys. They ours. We created them. We're all supposed to take care of them. No doubt. What's good with y'all? We vibing. We vibing, man. How y'all feeling? Shardy V, China, Last Teacher, R Focus Media, Marco.
I'm vibing, you know what I mean? I'm over here just listening, rolling. I'm over here vibing, you know what I mean?
Feeling good, feeling good.
As y'all should.
Yeah, I'm feeling great, man. It was a great day for LA, boy. They get Dodgers, Lakers, USC. You had the concert at the end to it. So I had the high school football game.
Traffic, it sounded like traffic.
Hey, I was on Crenshaw last night at the open mic Freestyle Friday shit. The traffic missed us, so I was cool.
That's crazy.
It was LA, put it on for the city, man. Let's go.
Robert Abrams Adams said he a ninja tourist. I'm
wondering where you from.
I don't even know what that means, homie.
Yeah,
I don't know either. But how old are you? Where you from?
Like, man. I'm damn near about to take interest in it, but that's changing my energy. Let me not do that, y'all.
Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving, man.
Let's see. Let's go back to some. Man, this is what we're going to do, y'all. Again, I'd like to thank everybody for tapping in to KGCN Radio, the Good Conversation Show. I'm hanging out with my brothers and sisters, no doubt. Got a lot of knowledge, information from the Last Teacher. Keep doing what you doing, fam, and everybody else. Let's get it. Yeah, but how old are you and where you from, fam? say you 45 from the Chicago area. That's cool. I still don't understand your ninja comment. Being that you a redhead skateboarder, I'm just trying to figure this out. Who was it a joke on and who was it a joke to? Because we just met you. Very superstitious, like Stevie said. No doubt. Let me see how to do this. I just want to say, brother, a blessing is a desecration. It's a sacrifice. We look for love over here. We don't do blessings. We do love. And if it can't just be that, if your jokes is at someone's or some race expense, we don't do that. If you're feeling that your chosen makes you better than someone else or anything, we don't do that. This is a safe space and a safe place for people to come and be who they are, but not be disrespectful. I'm not going to go for that. So before I block you, man, I just want to let you know, your tongue could be a choking hazard in real life. So watch what you say to people, man. All right, y'all, let's get back to it, man.
Real talk, before the next song goes ahead, I'm going to go and get my podcast episode recorded, but it's been great to talk with all of y'all and hear your stories, and definitely we'll come back to KGCN Radio.
No
doubt. Thank you for inviting me up, guys.
Appreciate you, no doubt, man. You have a good one, man. You stay doing your work, man, and making sure them kids get everything they can get, bro. I appreciate you.
All right, have a good one, Callie. Have a good one, Shorty, Tommy, Marco.
No doubt, man. Yeah, Shorty, I have to get him.
I understand, because he was talking down that record.
Yeah, you already know. He was just walking around, getting very disrespectful, very racist. He was walking around it. No. You know what I'm saying?
I know he was trying to be funny with it, but hey.
Yeah, but y'all know what's up, man. We chilling. We finna get into it. We got a few more minutes left. Let's go.
We'll be right back. told me to put a love of them as a bag of a super top. And they said that what I want is that all that I want, that I want, all that I want is a little pop at the top of the sky, and I said that all that I want is just a little bit of bomb, 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 bomb. It's the way of the warrior, waiting the waters of water for crystal clear lyrical smears, pitches the ears like Mike's pointed at monitors, receive a fever like a thermometer, we burning, we'll turn it back like thermostats, burning like Mississippi and furnaces and thermoses and gas, right after brats, right after that, we be cooling, jump back in the pooling, this is Samurai, how are you doing, I'ma be the one that you like turkeys in the getter, gather round you receptors. Come and look inside of these walls like metal detectors. If they could talk, they would probably say it's all damage. Just my thoughts goes off, even if it's off, but never caught. Houseway, how yay, trial day, know exactly just what I'll say. When they ask whatever I'll say, no idea. Then you approach the bench with no IKEA to build your case. Feeling safe but still escape, or chill in place. Around a bunch of sinners who feeling great, or around a bunch of niggas who innovate, take real estate, gentrify different sides like Geminis, energize like the Starship Enterprise.
No doubt, China, we about to go as well.
Yo goes Luna and Sumo to try to run in my shoes. Gotta throw your boomers to Pluto. Harati and those Harachis, only supers get that judo. How far your soul go? It's so far, it's so low, it's so low. It's no show and anti and social. Turn Gary to gold, coast move gold, post some soldier to toll, rolls a toll, bro. I'm number one. Put the gold in the gold hunt, turn gold in the Voltron. I'm the number one headband wearer. Walking like I talk and never falsing like Farrah. Headphones on the train, head banging to the snare. I put it in your range, let it wang like Vera. For everyone, stereo feel like steroids to carry. Heavy shit to pick up, much you could barely lift. Now you Larry Wills, done to bring it back to the flesh. Just flip it over, put it back in the deck. I'ma be the one that you.
Thank you.
she was demonstrating, but nevertheless I was pleased.
I was pleased.
My day was going great, and my soul was at ease. Until a group of brothers started bugging out, drinking the 40 ounce, going the nigger out. Disrespecting my black queen, holding their crosses and being obscene. At first I ignored it, cause see I know the type. They got drunk, they got guns, and yes they wanna fight. And they see a young couple having a time that's good. And the Eagles wanna test the brothers' manhood. Test speech cause of my heritage and the loud bright colors that I wear.
Boom.
I was a target cause I'm a fashion misfit. And the outfit that I'm wearing, brothers dissing it. While I stay calm and pray the niggas leave me be. But they squeeze the parts of my date's anatomy. Why Lord, your brothers have to drill me? Cause if I stop and hit this man, I'll have to kill me.
No doubt, no doubt. Thank y'all for tapping in with your boy on this Soul to Soul Saturday morning. I'm going to get up out of here. Traffic jam probably won't happen because I got some things to do and some things to get into. But definitely appreciate everybody for coming up here, sharing their stories, all the people that tapped in, all the people around the world, iHeartRadio, Spotify Radio, SoundCloud, Pandora, wherever you get your music needs. You are appreciated. Thank you for tapping the KGCN Radio, the Good Conversation Show. But before we get up out of here, y'all know how we do. We got to let our people that rock with us shout out and say peace out to the people. Marco Wayne.
Just want to say have a good day. And don't forget to smile at someone. Peace.
No doubt. Our Focus Media.
Yo, yo, everybody have a great day today. I know I am. Just look for the blessings in your day. Or look for the love in your day. There it is.
No doubt. Hey, you going to that Kush Fest situation today?
Nah, I ain't hitting up the Kush Fest, but I'm going to go check out the homie Rockbox and they situation. I told him I'd look out for him, so I'm going to check that out tonight.
No doubt, no doubt. That's what's up. Shorty V.
I'll see y'all around Podbean today. I have a show on the Tweet Lounge. 5 to 7 Pacific, 8 to 10 Eastern. We doing late night over there,
and we getting young bosses with a shizzle, man. Hopefully,
see y'all there.
Mic check. Yeah, yeah, no doubt, no doubt. With that being said, y'all, we definitely appreciate y'all again for hanging out with us. Y'all know the rules around here. Y'all stay safe. We're gonna do the same. Peace.
10, 9, 8, 7.